Well, it's going to be a cool and breezy day this afternoon, but lots of sunshine. In fact, it's going to be clearer tonight, so we're looking at patchy frost potentially for the upstate, and then of course some areas of freezing as we go into the mountains. Rain will return on Easter Sunday, so if you do want to get out and maybe enjoy a little bit of the outdoors, today and tomorrow will be the best days for that. We've got a wind advisory in effect for the mountains until 6 o'clock tonight. This of course is as we have winds between 25 and 35 miles per hour. We've also got a freeze warning in effect for these areas in blue, also parts of the mountains. I will say these areas highlighted are sub-freezing conditions. Most of you that live in the mountains will have temperatures at freezing or maybe a degree or two above, so it's going to be a cold night. And then we've got this, kind of rare, but it's the second day in a row we've had a fire weather warning. This is for the areas in pink or red, depending on the color of your screen. We've got very low humidity and very gusty winds, and those two things combined help increase our fire weather danger, so maybe don't grill today. That's definitely words to the wise. We've got some pretty significant wind gusts at times today, anywhere between 20 to 35 miles an hour. That's been just this morning. We'll see that kind of continue as we go into this afternoon and evening. And then as we fast forward to Sunday, we've got a slight risk of severe weather for all of our viewing area just to the west of us in portions of Georgia, Tennessee, Alabama. We've got an enhanced risk and even a moderate risk. So you can see it's not far from us. The main threat right now looks to be strong winds, isolated hail, and tornadoes cannot be ruled out with this particular system, looking at kind of a widespread outbreak of severe weather, particularly Sunday night into early Monday morning. That looks to be the timing right now. I will say a lot of this will depend on the track of that particular system, and that does have a tendency to change a few miles over time. So we'll be watching that very carefully and of course keeping you updated. That's Sunday. This is today. It's going to be beautiful, sunny and cool. In fact, we're going to be in the 50s for most of the day, finally getting into the low 60s as we get into this afternoon. Tomorrow, low humidity, sunny skies, a perfect spring-like Saturday. It's going to be great out there. And then Sunday morning, I mean, almost as soon as Sunday begins, here comes the rain. Some of it will be heavy at times and it will last throughout the day. And then overnight, this is 3 a.m. Monday, overnight Sunday into early Monday, that's right now looks to be the biggest time frame for severe weather. Again, that could change. As we head into Monday, we'll gradually clear out nicely. And as of right now, most of at least the first part of next week looks to be dry. Temperatures below the seasonal average for the first time in a long time, at least consistently. For the mountains, take a look at your overnight lows. Tonight, it's definitely going to be cold. But even next week, overnight lows dropping into and looking like staying in the 30s.